Carmen, and welcome to KHTV Summer Week 2. This week we have balloons, 4th of July, Latin Festival, and so much more. Let's check it out.
Line. Let Philadelphia freedom ring and patriotic voices sing. Red, white, and blue, never give up. You represent America!
Hoping and praying for a brighter day. I listen to my heart and I obey. How can I see it any other way? I'm looking at life
with
my own eyes.
And now to start off our week, we have a look at last week's 4th of July festivities.
It's a new day, and I feel good. If I wanna spread my wings, I know that I could. I got a feeling that tonight begins a killing. Will we all?
KHSTV was down at the Strand to film the Latino Festival. Let's see how that went.
On Saturday, down at the Strand, the 11th annual Latin Festival was held. There were many bands that played Latin cultured music, Also, many people got up and showed their Latin spirit despite the rain. KHSTV spoke to many people down at the Strand, including Drew, who has a nonprofit dance organization, and Monica, who is running for a state senate position in New York.
A wellness managing director and artistic director at the Center for Creative Education. I organize all of our activities at CCE. We were presenting today Zumba and some of the dance programs and music programs and educational programs that we offer at CCE in Midtown Kingston, 15 Railroad Avenue.
I am running as an independent Democrat, which means that I'm really truly looking to represent the people in my district. I'm not looking to protect the party or to protect the status quo. I'm really looking to represent the voice of the community. I've not run for office before. I'm not a career politician, and that's exactly why I'm running. I'm a regular person looking to bring some change to Albany.
There are also many vendors out at the Strand, including food vendors of Latin culture.
We sell Puerto Rican food. It's authentic, so pretty much everything is cooked on the premises, and it's old school remedies.
The Latin Festival is enjoyed by both young and old on Saturday. Reporting for KHSTV, I'm Allie Justy.
Hey guys, we're at the Strand for this year's Latino Festival. And this, today, KHSTV is going to be launching a new segment called Stuff Kingston Knows. I'm going to explain how this works really quick. All right, I have 9 questions about Latino heritage. I'm going to be going around asking people to see how much they know. If someone can answer the question right, then Kingston gets a point. If no one can answer the question right, then KHSTV gets a point. First team to 5 points wins. KHSTV versus Kingston. Let's go. All right, first question. This is 3. All right. What is the significance of Cinco de Mayo?
Cinco de Mayo is a celebration and the liberation of the Hispanic, I believe, in Mexico.
I think it was a liberation event, and it's a big holiday for them. I think it's Independence Day for them.
Cinco de Mayo, that was, wasn't that the independence of Mexico?
That's actually what a lot of people think, but that's actually incorrect. Most people think that it's the Independence Day, but it's really the day that they invaded, that they repelled a much larger French army. So they were already independent, but that was a big day for them because they beat the French, which were like a big team country. All right. What political issue regarding Puerto Rico will be brought up this November?
Are you for real? I have no idea.
Just take a guess. It's Puerto Rico. It's Puerto Rico.
I don't know, territory, something to do with territories, I don't know.
They want to secede, I don't know, I have no idea.
Some of the territories and...
I'll say the same thing, yeah.
Whether or not Dora the Explorer can come to the U.S.
They will be, I think, voting for whether they should continue to be a Commonwealth, a part of the United States, or independent.
That is correct. That'll be held on November 6th. They will be voting to determine that for the first time since 98. Yes, referendum.
Yep, that's it.
So maybe, possibly, we could end up with 51 states sometime this time next year.
Yeah, I'm from Puerto Rico.
Thank you. What is the largest Hispanic city in the world?
Largest Hispanic city in the world?
I would have to say... oh gosh.
I'm gonna go with Mexico.
I think it's America.
America? City.
City.
And a city in Mexico. I'm not sure. You know what, that might fail with Cuban too. Cuba.
If you probably said it, I'd probably say, oh okay, yeah, that one.
There's another one. Wouldn't it be Puerto Rico?
Would it be San Juan?
You're close with Mexico.
I'm closer to Mexico.
I don't know, New York City.
Dante! Okay. We don't know.
Puerto Vallarta. That's the oldest one.
It may be the oldest, but the largest one is Mexico City.
Okay.
Yes. By land area, which is the largest Hispanic country?
By area? Brazil?
Spain.
Brazil?
Puerto Rico?
Argentina?
That is actually correct. Argentina is about twice the size of Mexico. from what European country does all North and South American Hispanic culture come from?
I don't know. I'd say either Spain or Italy, because I know Italy is the root of, like, Spanish, I think.
I would fair to say they originated from Spain.
I don't know. Portugal? I don't know. I don't know. Portugal.
Portugal.
Spain.
The correct answer is Spain. Yes. Spain. Yep. In what month does the United States recognize Spanish Heritage Month?
Well, can we say July?
You can if you want to. There's only 12 months.
December.
June.
We're celebrating it right now, so it's July.
You would think, right? You would think. Of course not.
Okay.
Of course not.
November.
That one is actually really close.
You know what? There's a conflict with that because we celebrate a parade in June, and that's all the Hispanics. And then there's another one in September. So I'm not sure. I'm thinking it's probably September because that's a big one too. I'm not sure. It's June or September.
It's held between September 15 and October 15.
Yes. You're the first person who got that correct. Exactly. So you were right on that. All right. Well, thank you.
That was nice. All right,
and I'll actually, do you know any facts about Hispanic dance that you could tell us?
Yes, I know that salsa actually began here, not here in Kingston, but in New York, the actual word salsa. And salsa actually is a culmination of different origins, different cultures that makes as the sauce. It was named after the sauce, salsa. So that's a fact.
So the dance came from the sauce, the name.
The dance came from kind of the comparison to sauce, the way sauce, because you have different ingredients. Same thing, that's how salsa was built, with different, with different influences from different cultures around the world.
All right, cool. That's actually really great because, like, the whole point of asking these questions is to get people to know stuff about
that stuff.
So, yeah, so thanks.
And thanks for the facts.
Yep. Okay.
This Friday is another Friday the 13th. There are three this year, and they're all 13 weeks apart. Some people believe in superstitions, so I took a test to see if they actually come true. Let's check it out.
This week's episode of KHTV Summer.
Make sure you tune in next week when we cover the Children's Day Parade and a little bit of boating.
Reporting for KHSTV, I'm Allie Justy.
I'm Ethan Burwell.
And I'm Emily Gorman.
See you guys next week.
Yay! Can we all explode?
Looking at life through my own eyes.
dynamite. Plant Philadelphia, freedom ring, and patriotic voices sing. Red, white, and blue, never give up. You represent America!
Hoping and praying for a brighter day. I listen to my heart and I obey. How can I see it?